Right, well, I'm here in the company of the president. And you're known as much for your mindset as for your tennis, particularly in the British media. You're always portrayed as the unflappable, the nice man from Sweden, etc. Is that something you had to work on? Or?
No, I think with experience, playing for so many years, playing so many matches, going out to practice so many hours a day, I think it's a learning process. You know? I mean, when you were young, I was like kind of a crazy guy through the racket cheating, and finally they suspended me on the court. Learning the process, because tennis is such a mental game, psychologically, and I think it's that makes the difference between a great player, different other players. The most important points, key points in a match, those are the points you should win, and you hope to win. I mean, that's what's the difference between players on top and just people to the rest.
Practice, etc. How does the Masters game differ from, say, the Grand Slam game? You know, as you get older, is the game different? Is it more physical, more mental?
Well, I think the Masters game is. I mean, you were talking about us.
Yes.
I think coming to play, for instance, this thing in Marbella Masters is a great event, and the people who organize the tournament, Anders Borg and some other people, they're doing a great job. The players enjoy it very much. The thing is, when we go out on the court and play, we like to compete. We enjoy it. We enjoy playing matches. We enjoy playing points. We try to win, and we try to do our best. If we should lose, it's not the end of the world, but still we have a great time out there. And of course, you have all this like winning thing for the players. And you know, I still enjoy playing tennis very much.
And one last thing, I mean, you're as much an icon as you are a tennis player. You've got about 70 sort of set, I would say. You know, like George Best, the footballer, James Hunt, the racing driver, and then of course yourself. You seem to be in a brilliant sport, but also you had a great life with it. All the ladies talking about it. Are you glad you're part of that era, or do you look at today's era and think, well, you'd like to be a part of that too?
Well, if you put it this way, I'm very happy with what I did for tennis. What I gave tennis and what tennis gave me. I was very successful over the years. I was very professional what I was doing, and it came from my heart. I enjoyed every single bit. So that if people, if they ask me like this, what do you want to be remembered of in tennis, I would just to be remembered as a great tennis player.
And that would be your advice for any youngster growing up today?
Well, it's a long way to go to be a great tennis player, but you need the heart, you need the motivation, you have to spend a lot of time on the tennis court to work, and even off the court you have to do a lot of hard work too, but long way. If you have that drive and you have the heart for it, you can be very successful.
Thank you so much for your second.